Hello students, in today's lecture we'll study regarding solenoid valve. So we'll start with the solenoid valve. So basically we'll define a valve. So a valve is a mechanical device for controlling the flow of a fluid or a substance. Okay, it controls the flow of a fluid or substance. A solenoid is a coil of a wire that becomes magnetized when electricity is run through it. Okay. Solenoid valve uses electricity to open and close an orifice in the valve body, allowing or preventing the flow of a given medium. This type of a valve is opened and closed by plunger that is raised and lowered by energizing and de-energizing of a solenoid. A solenoid valve uses a solenoid to activate a valve. This lets you control the flow of water, air, or other substances with electricity. This is a magnetic effect of electric energy as shown in this figure. So spiral spring as shown in this diagram, valve plate, then this is a flow of liquid as shown in this diagram, the push rod seal, valve housing as shown in the diagram, then electric power connection is given here, magnet coil and protective cover as shown in this diagram. So this is a diagrammatical representation. Then valve types, that is a popular types of on off solenoid valves are directly pilot operated and propositioning valve. So in the direct lip, a direct lip solenoid valve has a plunger that opens or closes the valve. Direct lip solenoid valves usually have low flow rates and high differential pressure drops. They normally have a quicker response than pilot operated valves. And next is a pilot operated valves. In this pilot operated solenoid valves uses the fluid's own pressure for activation. The valves are either piston or diaphragm type and usually require differential pressure to keep the valve closed. So main in this pilot operated, a pilot operated solenoid valve uses the fluid's own pressure for activation. Because they do not have a plunger, pilot operated solenoid valves are normally available in large orifice size than direct lip valves. Okay, so solenoid valve basic principle we have to study. In that basic principle, solenoid valve is an electrically controlled valve. The valve features a solenoid, which is an electric coil with a movable ferromagnetic core, also called as a plunger, in its center. In the rest position, the plunger closes off a small orifice and electric current through the coil creates a magnetic field. The magnetic field exerts an upward force on a plunger opening the orifice. This is basic principle that is used to open and close the solenoid valve. So very basic principle, that is there is a ferromagnetic core and the valve feature solenoid, which is an electric coil with a movable ferromagnetic core or plunger in its center. Okay, and when electricity is given, according to that current through the coil creates a magnetic field and there is a opening and closing action. Okay, a solenoid valve consists of two main components, a solenoid and valve body. This is a valve body. Figure shows components. A solenoid has an electromagnetic inductive coil. So this is electromagnetic inductive coil A as shown in this diagram around an iron core at the center called the plunger. At the center, this is a plunger. At rest, it can be normally open or normally closed. In the de-energized state, a normally open valve is open and normally closed valve is a closed. When current flows through the solenoid, the coil is energized. And creates a magnetic field as previously mentioned, and this creates a magnetic attraction with the plunger, moving it and overcoming the spring D force. Okay, due to magnetic field generation, there is a as shown as mentioned, this creates a magnetic attraction with plunger. If the valve is normally closed, the plunger is lifted so that seal F opens the orifice and allows the flow of the media through the valve. So this is a seal, F is a seal. If the valve normally closed, the plunger is lifted so that seal F opens, this seal opens and there is a flow of a liquid from this side to this side. And when closed, as shown in this figure, there is no movement of fluid. If the valve is normally closed, the plunger is lifted, so the seal F opens and orifice and allow the flow of media through the valve. If the valve is normally open, the plunger moves downward so that seal F blocks the orifice and stops the flow of the media through the valve. The shading ring C, this is a shading ring C, prevents vibration and humming in AC coils. Solenoid valves are used in a wide range of application with high or low pressure and small or large flow rates. These solenoid valves use different operating principles that are optimal for the application. The most of the important ones are explained in this article, that is direct acting, indirect acting, semi-direct acting. So one by one we study. So in that solenoid valve, there are again different types, that is a two-way solenoid valve. A two-way solenoid valve has two ports. This is a one port and this is another port, an inlet and outlet. Flow direction is critical to ensure proper operation. So there is typically an arrow indicating the flow direction. A two-way valve is used to open or close the orifice. Figure shows the example of two-way solenoid valve. Then next is a three-way solenoid valve. A three-way solenoid valve has three connection ports as shown in this diagram. This is one, second, and this is a third. It has two states. It can be in, so it switches between two different circuits. A three-way valve is used to open, close, distribute, or mix media. Figure shows an example of three-way solenoid valve. Solenoid valve types. For normally closed solenoid valve, the valve is closed. Okay, this is a valve is closed. The valve is closed when de-energized, the media cannot flow through it. When the current is sent the coil, it creates electromagnetic field that forces the plunger upward, overcoming the spring force. So this plunger moves upward, and as it moves upward, it is also moved in upward direction, and there is a flow of a fluid. This unsets the seal and opens the orifice, allowing the media the flow through the wall. Figure shows the operating principle of a normally closed solenoid valve in the de-energized and energized state. Okay, so as there is a movement of this piston, you can so say this is a movement is in upward direction, and this closing is open, and there is a flow of liquid as shown in this diagram. There is, in this first case, there is no movement of a fluid, but when it moves in upward direction, there is a flow of a fluid. For normally open solenoid valve, the valve is open. This valve is open. When de-energized, the media can flow through it. So media can flow through it. When current is sent to the coil, it creates electromagnetic field that forces the plunger downward, overcoming the spring force. So this moves in a downward direction. Due to this, valve is closed, and there is a stop of a fluid movement, or fluid movement cannot takes place here. The seal is then seating the orifice and closing it, which prevents media from flowing through the valve. Figure shows the operating principle of a normally open solenoid valve in the de-energized and energized state. A normally open solenoid valve is ideal for application that require the valve to be open for long periods of time, as this is then more energy efficient. Then next is a bistable solenoid valve. A bistable or latching solenoid valve can be switched by momentary power supply. It will then stay in that position with no power. Therefore, it is not normally open or normally closed as it stays in the current position when no power is applied. They accomplish this by using permanent magnets rather than a spring. So, direct acting or direct operated solenoid valves, diagrammatical representation as shown in this diagram. For normally closed valve with no power, the plunger E blocks the orifice. This plunger E blocks the orifice with the wall seal F. A spring D is forcing this closure. This spring D is forcing this closure. When power is applied to the coil A, it creates an electromagnetic field. When power is applied to the coil A, it creates an electromagnetic field attracting the plunger up. Attracting this plunger upward side, attracting the plunger up, overcoming the spring force. This opens the orifice and allows the media to flow through. A normally open valve has the same components but works in the opposite way. The maximum operating pressure and flow rate are directly related to the orifice diameter and the magnetic force of the solenoid valve. Therefore, direct acting solenoid valve is typically used for relatively small flow rates. Direct operated solenoid valves require no minimum operating pressure or pressure difference, so they can be used from 0 bar up to maximum allowable pressure. So this is a direct acting solenoid valve working principle as previously mentioned. This is a coil A. When current is provided, it is magnetized and this spring you can say goes upward side. This E means seal or plunger goes into the upward side and F is a seal which is open and there is a flow of a liquid as shown in this diagram. So C is coil components as a coil. A is a coil, then B is a armature. This is armature. C is a shading ring, then D is a spring, E is a plunger. This is a plunger that is a due to generation of magnetic field, this plunger goes upward side or downward side as per requirement, that is to keep this valve open or close. Indirect acting solenoid valve, also called servo operated or pilot operated, use the pressure differential of a medium over the wall inlet and outlet ports to open and close the valve. So as previously mentioned, these are the pilot operated, and in this use the pressure differential of the medium over the wall inlet. Means ये जो फ्लूड है उसका प्रेशर यूज करते हैं फॉर ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग द वॉल. इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज इनडायरेक्ट एक्टिंग सोलेनॉइड वॉल. देयर आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज पायलट ऑपरेटेड. देयरफॉर दे टिपिकली रिक्वायर अ मिनिमम प्रेशर डिफरेंशियल ऑफ अराउंड 0.5 बार. द वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इनडायरेक्ट एक्टिंग सोलेनॉइड वॉल कैन बी सीन इन दिस डायग्राम. ओके, व्हेन प्रेशर इज क्रिएटेड दिस coil or this diaphragm goes on upward side and there is a flow of a liquid. The inlet and output ports are separated by rubber membrane. This is a rubber membrane, also called as a diaphragm. The membrane has a small hole so that medium can flow to the upper compartment from the inlet. For normally closed indirect acting solenoid valve, the inlet pressure above the membrane and supporting the spring above the membrane will ensure that valve remains closed. As previously mentioned, in this indirect acting solenoid valve, also called as servo operated or pilot operated valve, the chamber above the membrane is connected by small channel to low pressure port. This connection is blocked in the closed position by plunger and wall seal. So this is a plunger and this is a wall seal. Diameter of this pilot officer is a orifice is a larger than the diameter of the hole in the membrane. When the solenoid is energized, the pilot orifice is opened, which causes the pressure above the membrane to drop. Because of the pressure difference on the both sides of the membrane will be lifted and the medium can flow from the inlet port to the outlet port. So this fluid can move from this side to this side when there is a this diagram diaphragm moves on upward side. According to that, this seal is open. Okay. And normally open wall has the same components but works in the opposite way. So next is a semi-direct acting solenoid valves. Semi-direct acting solenoid valves combine the properties of direct and indirect valves. This allows them to work from zero bar. They can still handle a high flow rate. They look similar to indirect valves and also feature a movable membrane with small orifice and pressure chamber on both sides. So semi-direct is a combination of properties of direct and indirect valves. Okay, ये word ध्यान में रखो, combination of direct and indirect valve. The working principle of a semi-direct acting solenoid valve can be seen as shown in this diagram. When the plunger is lifted, it directly lifts the membrane to open the valve. This to open the valve. At the same time, second orifice is opened by the plunger that has slightly larger diameter than the first orifice in the membrane. This causes the pressure in the chamber above the membrane to drop. As a result, the membrane is lifted not only by the plunger but also by the pressure difference. Then next is the application of a solenoid valve. So n number of applications. First, that is a common domestic and industrial solenoid valve applications. It includes refrigeration systems. Use solenoid valves to reverse the flow of refrigerant. This helps in cooling during summer and heating during winter. Then in irrigation system, uses solenoid valve with automatic control. Then dishwashers. In dishwashers and washing machines, use solenoid valves to control the flow of water. Okay, in washing machine. Then in air conditioning system, it solenoid valves to control the air pressure. Solenoid valves are used in automatic locking system for door locks. Then in medical and dental equipment, solenoid valves are used to control the flow, direction and pressure of fluid. Then solenoid valves can also be used in water tanks to control the inflow or outflow of water, often in combination with flow switch. Then in car washes to control the water and soap flow. So in washing center, car washing center, solenoid valves are also used. Then in industrial cleaning equipment, so to clean the industrial equipment, to increase the pressure, to increase the pressure of a fluid, for that purpose these solenoid valves are used. So very important functions in refrigeration, in irrigation, in air conditioning. Okay, then in automatic locking system for door lock, medical and dental equipments. Okay, water tanks use the solenoid valves. So to control the flow of liquid, you can say to stop the flow of liquid and to open the flow of liquid, these solenoid valves are useful. And it uses the, as previously we have mentioned, the working principle of these solenoid valves. Okay, thanks for attending the lecture. Thanks.